And welcome back to Clinically Speaking. Today, I'm going to talk about the nation's mental health crisis and how important it is to address mental health as individuals, employers, and plans. The U.S. is experiencing a national mental health crisis that emerged even before COVID-19. According to the National Institutes of Health, 1 in 5 American adults, about 52 million people, struggle with mental illness, and less than half receive treatment. The pandemic has only exacerbated this situation. According to a 2021 study from the Kaiser Family Foundation, approximately 4 in 10 adults nationwide report symptoms of anxiety or depressive disorder during the pandemic, a 4-fold increase from pre-pandemic levels. There are many factors that contribute to heightened levels of stress and anxiety: social isolation, job loss and other economic effects, potential COVID exposure, particularly for those on the front lines, and new family life challenges, such as balancing remote working with managing virtual schooling for children. More recently, as we return to normalcy, with employees coming back to the workplace in some capacity, the American Psychological Association reported the highest level of stress in the U.S. since April of 2020. Half of the adults report being uneasy about returning to in-person interactions, feelings that are heightened as the highly contagious Delta variant continues to plague the U.S. Our mental health plays a huge role in our general well-being. According to a recent study, 92% of adults living with mental disorders also have a physical health condition. Being in a healthy mental state can help prevent progression to more severe disease. On the flip side, poor mental health is a risk factor for chronic conditions such as diabetes, asthma, cancer, cardiovascular disease, and arthritis. The mind-body connection is amplified as higher levels of anxiety and stress are shown to lead to additional unhealthy behaviors, such as increased substance use and lower levels of physical activity. For example, people living with a mental health condition are more likely to smoke. And among smokers, those with mental health conditions are more likely to smoke a greater number of cigarettes. People experiencing mental health conditions also struggle with seeking care, taking their medications as prescribed, and getting exercise, factors that are necessary to control chronic conditions. It's no surprise that poor mental health has costs for health plans and employers. Research shows that employers see 8 to 11% lost work productivity for employees with symptoms of major depression. But taking steps to improve the mental health of members and employees can reduce net cost of care, especially among individuals suffering from multiple chronic conditions. Some studies indicate the savings can be as high as 20%. So what barriers confront many of the 45% of American adults suffering with mental health conditions who are not being treated? It's not for lack of trying. Many are simply unable to get an appointment due to the severe shortage of mental health professionals in the U.S. In all, 121 million Americans live in communities with a shortage of mental health professionals, and access varies significantly across states. Telehealth is helping to close some of the gaps in behavioral health care, and people are embracing it. In our recent MD Live Consumer Telehealth Attitudes and Usage Survey, 55% of respondents said they were open to using telehealth for mental health services, citing 2 core advantages. 1, the ability to get care from the comfort of wherever they are. And 2, the overall feeling of being in a safe space to talk with someone about sensitive issues. We encourage health plans and employers to revisit the behavioral health benefits available to their population. Be sure you have the right elements in place to provide access to mental health services, such as a telehealth option for connecting with a behavioral health provider from where people feel comfortable and safe. Thanks for joining today. We'll be back in the coming weeks with more Clinically Speaking. Be sure to sign up for weekly news, insights, and updates at evernorth.com. Until next time, make it your choice to be healthy, be safe, and be well-informed every day.